guys, good morning. Today I want to talk to you about too much calcium in our body, why too much calcium is not good for us, what are the main signs, symptoms and causes, and how can we help us naturally. Why naturally, guys? I don't like too much drugs, and I'm not taking, even if I'm getting some sickness, usually I'm not taking paracetamol, ibuprofen and these kind of things. So I will not recommend you to go in the nearest pharmacy and go for some supplements. What I will recommend you is how naturally to get rid of the problem. So let's start it. First of all, too much calcium in our body is called hypercalcemia. And hypercalcemia, the first symptom of hypercalcemia, this is the bone pain. If you guys experience abnormal bone pain, which you never have been experienced before in your life, please make sure you're going and check with your physician or your GP. And please ask them to make you a blood test, in which blood test they can tell you how much calcium you contain, how much calcium contained in your blood, not in your bones, because it's normal to contain calcium in your bones, but in your blood. They should make you a blood test, and they should tell you how much it is. And if it's too much, that is one of the reasons why you have a bone pain. Second, guys, if you have if you experience this is a condition called insomnia. This is the condition of the body when you're very tired, you're exhausted, but you can't go to sleep. Then you should look for medical attention. And if, for example, 1-2 days you can't really sleep, really you can't get any sleep, you should go immediately to speak with your GP or in emergency, because this is very dangerous for you. Why, guys? Because like the computers and everything, when they're overloaded, they need to rest. Same is with us. If we are very tired, it's very normal to go and sleep. And if your head cannot turn off, that means you have some problem. Most of the problems of insomnia is when you're having too much calcium in your body. Okay, guys. Also, another symptom, this is excessive urination. If you have excessive urination, then you might experience too much calcium in your body. That means even if you're not taking too much liquids per day and you're still going too often, there is a problem. But for example, if you're drinking 2-3 liters a day and you're going to toilet more often, that is a normal. It's absolutely normal to the kidneys to get rid of the the bladder to get rid of the water. Okay, guys? Also, if you're urinating too often, that can mean not only because you're having too much calcium, but because maybe you are diabetic or you have some other diseases. Also, guys, if you're having high blood pressure, that is one of the signs of or symptoms of too much calcium. If your anxiety, if you are having asthma, bronchitis, that may be because you're having too much calcium in your body. Why is that, guys? I will explain you very simple. First, calcium is a heart mineral. And this heart mineral, when we take it with the food or with the supplements, if you're taking supplements, some of the calcium will go to the bones, but some of the calcium will go to our blood cells, arteries, soft tissues, soft organs. And what is going to happen when every day you're taking these supplements? I'm speaking about the supplements because from food is not that you're not taking that much calcium like from natural drugs. So when you're taking every day this calcium supplements, then you're starting to plug in your soft tissues too much calcium, and then any soft organs, and then they stop to work properly. For example, I'll give you an example. If you're having in your kidney stones, That is one of the reasons. Or you have in your gallbladder stones, that is another reason. So every day when you're taking supplements, calcium supplements, they're actually, instead of putting in the bones, they're transporting the calcium in your kidneys or your gallbladder or maybe both places, and they're little by little every day they're building their stones, and these stones are very painful. Who suffer from them, they know what is the pain, and that no one wants to go through this. So what else, guys? Where calcium can go? Calcium can, too much calcium can go to your eyes, and this is called cataracts. Also can go in your artery. You know, artery is through the artery is going the blood flow, and if in the artery there is too much calcium, the artery, which artery is very soft, is becoming hard, and it's hard the blood to flow through the artery. So also calcium is plugging in your lungs, in your heart, and making them to work harder because they're becoming, for example, one lung is hard, is very soft, and when you are taking these supplements little by little, is starting to build more calcium in your lungs, and they become more hard, and they're hard to function. I mean, difficult to function. So what can cause as well, what can cause too much calcium in your body? That is when you have a lack of vitamin D3, or you have lack of vitamin K2 or vitamin F. What I mean, if you're not taking enough sunlight, or you're not eating too much foods which contains vitamin D3, that can be one of the causes to have too much calcium in your body. But also, if there is even another case, in case you're taking too much vitamin D3 as well, the body can have the same problem, like taking too much calcium and transporting this calcium not in the proper places like the bones, but transporting in your blood cells or soft tissues, which is not good. What else, guys, you need to do? You need to take proper vitamin D3. And also, I don't recommend you to get vitamin D by supplements. Please get it naturally. There is so many foods. I already spoke about vitamin D3, which you can take it from fish, from nuts, from seeds, from sun. Also, K2. Vitamin K2, you can find K2 in chicken liver, duck liver, beef liver, in a beef steaks, but this beef steaks, which is grass-fed, if you can find organic grass-fed beef steaks, that will be nice. Vitamin K, what vitamin K2 is doing is actually blocking the calcium to build up in your soft tissues. Also, you need to eat more food full of magnesium. Why, guys? Because magnesium as well is helping the calcium to be blocked. I mean, this calcium, which is not going to your bones but is going to your soft tissues, is damaging everything. So make sure you're eating and drinking foods high in magnesium, high in vitamin D3, fine K2, and high as well in vitamin F, which is most known, like that is contained in fish oils, in flaxseed oil, if you can find them, and you have diseases like osteoporosis, arthritis, and you are a woman who is about 50 years old, is good, guys, to start to drink that kind of things and eat that kind of things to help yourself with that problem, with the too much calcium. Also, guys, I want to tell you something. If you experience depression, stress, which you don't know from where it's coming, you're vomiting, you have diarrhea, for example, you have high blood pressure, you're very confused. You don't know what's going on in your life. You're one day you're happy, next day you're not happy. You're quite moody. You don't have too much like energy. You're feeling all the time tired. You can't sleep very well and everything. What else I will recommend you guys is to go and check yourself. What you need to check, guys, is not only your blood, but you need to speak to your GP, because sometimes too much calcium in your body could mean that you have, for example, tumor. And where is this tumor? You know, our thyroid gland is here, and behind this thyroid gland there is another four little parathyroid glands. And if one of them or some of them have tumor, that is why one of the reasons that you can have too much calcium in your body. Why, guys? Because these four parathyroid glands are regulating the calcium in our body. And if you have tumor in one of them or two of them, you need immediately to seek attention from a medical attention. You need to go to get operated. And once this tumor is removed from your body, then your body will start to regulate the calcium, and you will start to feel more active. You start to feel like yourself. So also make sure if you're having itchiness, hives, excessive urination, constipation, asthma, high blood pressure, make sure you're going and checking yourself for too much calcium in your body. Make sure you're checking as well the parathyroid glands. In case some of them is affected, then that might need to go to be removed. I heard the operation is taking around 20-25 minutes, and it's not dangerous. So many women who had the problem with their bones, with their muscle, they have cramps as well and everything. Once the doctors by surgery remove the pyro gland, which is affected, then their body starts to function properly and they feel active, they sleep well, they feed well, and they feel much more younger than they were. So guys, what I'm going to do in my next videos, I'm going to start to speak about magnesium. What are the high rich in food in magnesium? Why, guys? Because magnesium is very important. Magnesium in our body is blocking this calcium, this excessive calcium. So if you want, follow me. If you like this video, like it. If you want to see more videos from me, please subscribe to my channel. Also, I'm going to talk about vitamin K in another video. I will stop. I will start to speak about magnesium, vitamin K2, about vitamin F, and how can we take them naturally so we can help our bodies to fight with too much calcium in our blood and our soft tissues. Okay, guys, I hope I was helpful. If you like my video, like it. If you want to see more from me, subscribe it. Have a nice day. Be healthy, be happy, be positive. Bye-bye.